Please welcome Kim Marsh.
Hello.
Hi. All right. How are you doing?
I'm all right. Yeah, yes. That was a bit dramatic.
It was a little bit. That's happening on Friday, is it? That
yeah,
bit that
Friday,
we just saw there.
Yeah. A bit disgusting, isn't it?
Was that your spit?
It was, yeah.
not stunt spit.
No, it was my spit. It was disgusting.
So to people who maybe aren't quite up to speed with it all, tell us what was happening there.
Well, basically, as we know, Tony's confessed to the murder of Liam. So, basically, I'm just going to find out when his court hearing's going to be and we all have to sit there. And it was nerve-wracking for her and stuff. And then he smiled at Ryan.
That was it.
That was nasty, yeah. That smile.
She's been quite composed till now, because Michelle tries to kind of look after everybody else. She's one of those kind of martyrs, if you like, and this is like the first time we've seen her, really.
But does she do that so she doesn't have to think about it, which a lot of women
probably
do?
Are you keep busy, like keep that yourself, busy. Do you think? Is that something you've put into the character? Or
yeah, I mean, I do kind of just try and get on with things, because my dad's, you know, my dad is very much kind of, you know, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger kind of thing. Mm. So, you know, whatever life throws at you, just kind of get on with it, really.
How do you bring about, you know, the kind of emotion that we saw there? How do you get yourself in the zone, as it were, when you're turning up to work, you've got to film something like that?
I tend to just kind of
do it,
think morbid things and do it. Yeah, you've just got to do it, haven't you? And I think those kind of scenes where you've got to be really kind of dramatic and kind of, you know, breaking down, they're quite easy, I think.
Also, it's so in a show like Corrie, you just haven't got time to be method, have you? Even if you were, there just isn't at the time. Just don't hit the furniture.
No. And you've got another fight scene coming up that you've already filmed, haven't you?
Oh, is that with Alison?
With Ali King,
Carla.
Yeah.
Who plays Carla.
Because obviously, you know, I'm going to find out that she knew much more than she let on and then just fled and didn't tell anyone, so I...
Is it
really
a proper girly cat fight?
Oh, it's a proper fight.
I couldn't do that.
Well, the thing is, if you get a fight like that, you've got to just go for it, because, as you know...
Well, like with Sally.
Because if you don't, it looks just looks rubbish.
It's great, though, because this is what Corrie's all about, these strong women. Mm. And so you two characters are carrying on that tradition, aren't you, really? And it's fantastic to
see. How long
have
you been in it now?
It's coming up for 4 years.
4 years?
Yeah. You had some good storylines in that 4 years, though.
Really
I'd like
good.
To say something nice happen to you, though. You're so often the victim, and I don't like that. You're too nice.
Oh, thanks. Do you know what? I've loved it, though, and I think I always say it would be really nice to see her settle down, you know, because fellas are always doing the dirty on her.
But
to be honest, it would be really boring, wouldn't it?
Can't she become a singer so you can get a few tunes in every episode?
Well, she came in as a singer, didn't she? And then we've never seen her.
But from your point of view, it must be lovely as well, because for the past 4 years you've had a little bit of stability. You know, the difference between doing something like Corrie and, you know, being a pop star and travelling all over the place, it must be good for you as a little family unit.
It's great, It doesn't take me away from, you know, I'm with them all the time, which obviously being on the road, you know, especially when you're kind of promoting a single, you've got a 6-week period where you're just constantly away doing things.
It
just didn't suit me at all.
Do you miss it though, ever?
Well, I'm really lucky because I still get to sing a lot. I do lots of charity events and things like that. So I get to do it now because I want to, and rather than because I've got to kind of do it to promote myself.
But would you like to be in a musical?
Yeah, well, I did Saturday Night Fever for 6 months in the West End. I'd love to go back, but I'd like to do a new musical like The Carpenters or something.
Singing The Carpenters. Yeah. Our friends have got this brilliant karaoke room, Robin and Julie, and I'm just constantly after a few going, do me a Carpenters.
But haven't you just got a lovely award for being a fantastic mum? Go on, tell us, brag. Go on.
I got Celebrity Mum of the Year. Yeah.
What do your kids think about that? How old are they now? 14 and 11?
Emily's 12 on Thursday, actually. Okay. So happy birthday for Thursday, even though, you know, I've said it publicly, Emily, just so you know. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Well, they love it, you know, and they just, you know, when I told them, they're like, well, you are the best mum, you know.
That's nice.
So I suppose, you know, you always think your mum's the best, don't you?
And, you know, we were talking there about Katie Price is obviously a single girl now. Do you think it's true that you have to be on your own to find yourself, or do you think you can do it within a relationship?
I think Yeah, you can, but I think in the public eye it's very difficult. Mm. And I think you know, the breakup of Katie and Peter was so public, you know, and I think because of that maybe she's not had time to kind of sit back. And her and Alex got together like a week or something after, or it seemed it probably wasn't, but it seemed really quick. So maybe it might be nice for her to kind of have some time.
And how about yourself? Because obviously your private life is very much out there in the public domain.
It is, but having said that, the breakdown of my marriage, both Jack and I never spoke about, and I think that was the key, really, because it seemed to kind of just, you know, it went away very quickly with regard to the newspapers. And I think had we both gone, well, he said this and she said that, and it makes it worse. So you just need to both go, you know what, that was our private thing. Mm-hmm. And
but you're back with your boyfriend, though.
I am. He's watching.
And how are things for you now? Because, you know, you've had a tough old year this year.
I really have. I've had a really, really bad year. But it's on the up. And that's the main thing. And I want to take an opportunity to thank everybody, because we really did have so much support from the public and emails and messages. And also doing the Tonight Show was a really great thing to do, because I've had, you know, a lot of emails from charities that apparently got an email from Tommy's yesterday saying that they'd had so many people ring them on the back of that show to want to donate and to help with the charity. So that to me was...
To turn such a negative, horrendous experience into something positive,
absolutely,
really.
Absolutely, and if it can help anybody else, and if it's raising money and people are phoning, then that's great, so thank you for that.
OK, we're really, really pleased for you that things are on the up. Good luck with Corrie, you're fab on it. We all enjoy seeing you. It's Kim Marsh, everyone.